Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
I'm here with Dr. Sudhir Bhandari, who is the principal of SMS College in Jaipur. It is the only testing facility in the city and the nodal hospital that is taking care of the coronavirus cases. Welcome to ThePrint, sir.
Can you begin by telling us a little bit about what the procedure is when a patient is admitted into the
facility? I must share with you that SMS Medical College Hospital is country's one of the biggest medical college hospitals. We have 12 attached hospitals. We are the nodal hospital for containment of the choroid program, the testing of the choroid, training of the manpower, personals. In fact, it is a fully geared hospital. In SMS Hospital, we have created a ICU facility dedicated to COVID of around 250 beds, which is scalable to almost 500 beds. Around 1200 beds have been kept reserved for COVID patients, but we may escalate it further by around 500 to 800 patients. We have dedicated COVID OPD. We have dedicated wards with the separate cubicles for suspects. We have dedicated wards for COVID positive who are asymptomatic, COVID positive who are mildly symptomatic, and COVID positive who are critical. In fact, the complete manpower has been put on duty by rotation. At the same time, we are privileged to have country's one of the best virology lab, and we have escalated our testing ability of PCR, which is a specific test for testing, to almost 1500 tests a day. Our teams are working 24/7 round the clock doing the PCR testing.
When a patient is admitted either for isolation or for further testing, what is the process that you follow and what is the protocol that you take if a patient's health deteriorates in that time?
For the patient care at the institute, all the protocols are followed. The standard protocols of distancing, the hand washing, the mask using, and all the interpersonal spreads are taken care of. Once the patient lands up at our OPD facility dedicated for COVID, he or she is screened by the team of doctors, analyzed. If there's any travel history, is any contact with a COVID suspect or COVID patient, if someone qualifies for COVID testing, then and there, we have the best trained technicians who take the sample. Now, if the patient is from outside and awaiting the COVID sample, we keep them in our suspect zone of the OPD block. And till the patient's report comes in 12 to 14 hours, patient is kept as a suspect in the separate cubicle. All logistic care of the patient is taken care. Once the first sample of the patient is negative and patient belongs to the city or the same place, we advise him for the home quarantine. But suppose the first sample comes out to be positive, then patient is shifted to the COVID positive wards. So we segregate the patients, and once the patient is COVID positive, he is kept as per his status in the different wards. A second sample and third sample also repeated every 2 or 3 days till the patient turns out to be COVID negative. Now, there has been a change in the guidelines of home quarantine also for asymptomatic COVID positive by Government of India also.
So the whole country is sort of facing a shortage of PPE and other safety equipment. Is that something that you are experiencing?
No.
And if not, then how is that so?
I must tell you, first of all, our government is so proactive, government is so supportive, administration is so supportive, that at no stage we sensed any deficiency in spite of being a nodal hospital catering whole of the state. We have plenty and adequate of all the PPE, the supportive treatment, the medications, etc. Secondly, ours is a great country. The way the social organizations, the way the private people, the way the doctors, the way the people at large are coming to be a part of providing all the necessary equipment, the necessary PPEs, the necessary support system, the N95 mask. We feel we are in a country blessed with the generous people. So I would say because of the great support, the unlimited support by the government, the administration, and unlimited support by the people at large, we have plenty of everything. We can cope up even if accidentally number of cases increase, we will be able to handle it. And if I share the statistics of my hospital, you'll be extremely happy. We are the only first institute in country who use the hydroxychloroquine. And SMS, our protocol in first three Italian patients, we use the hydroxychloroquine along with the antiretroviral drug. Can you believe so far in more than 170 positive patients, none of the patient only because of COVID is on ventilator. Only three patients we lost, they were senior citizens 80 plus with massive brain hemorrhage, heart problem or kidney problem. So we are very lucky to have used hydroxychloroquine. There was enough evidence was available in literature. We checked up under close supervision. We use hydroxychloroquine. We have been using it now in a select group of patients with a very positive results. We use antiviral drugs also. And out of 170 patients so far, only because of COVID, none of our patients is on ventilator. Only three patients are on oxygen, which they are also improving. Out of 170, 68 has turned out to be COVID negative twice, and we have sent them and discharged them.
I just wanted to ask a little bit further about, you know, your use of hydroxychloroquine and HIV and antiretroviral drugs, because both of these have been debated in the medical fraternity about their effectiveness with, you know, tackling the COVID-19 virus. So can you just maybe elaborate a little bit more about how it is that these drugs are...
Now, when you take about the effect of COVID, I must share with you, 80% of the patients have mild disease. They don't have any issues, especially they are middle-aged or young. 10 to 15% patients, they have mild pulmonary infections, which get cured by proper treatment. The challenge is only with 2 to 4% patients who are senior citizens, people who have high blood pressure, diabetes, heart problem, cancer, etc. When we got the first three COVID patients, the Italian citizens, you know, we have been reading and seen there was similar corona kind of infection like SARS as well as MERS in 2003 and 2009. We have the great experience of using hydroxychloroquine as an anti-inflammatory drug. We have been using this drug for rheumatoid arthritis, malaria, as well as lupus. We have known this, that hydroxychloroquine, and there's enough literature available, that it is a drug which acts as an immunomodulator, which blocks the receptor on the cells so that virus doesn't find entry into the cells. It changes the pH of the cells, so the virus replication is taken place. So whenever a COVID patient came to us, our intention was to give him best medical treatment, best supportive treatment. If anything under supervision, we can do to reduce the virus replication. So we have been using this drug for ages with practically no side effect. So we use this combination of drugs with marked carefulness under supervision. And we found that let us do something to reduce the virus replication. At the same time, there has been a research and documentation of using lopinavir and ritonavir as antiviral drug. Now, establishing a standard line of treatment, you require long trials, long studies, but there's always a good beginning. When there is so much of morbidity and mortality among COVID patients, even if a proactive role of ours by using hydroxychloroquine and antiretroviral drugs, we found a positive results. We thought it will be prudent to share with our fraternity so that all of us take it as a trial, as a research. We do more studies, put more patients under supervision, and we can give society something positive. So basically, we prefer to share our initial experience of hydroxychloroquine with the rest of our fraternity, but yes.
You work very closely with the Rajasthan government. What do you think will happen after the 14th? Because we're close approaching that date, which is when the lockdown is set to come to an end.
As an Indian public, we are at peak of our acclimatization. We have totally acclimatized to the present status of lockdown. You know, every Indian or average Indian is so well informed by media, by WhatsApp, by internet, that what is happening in the rest of the world. The results and the outcome of not following the lockdown, not following such a disciplined life, has been so dreadful in the America. You see, once upon a time, America talked about economic survival. Today, they talk about the human survival. So truly speaking, all of us have acclimatized totally. We are leading a very pious life. we have to suffer personal, social, economical hardships for a few weeks to have the phenomenon gains later. We are going to be winner of the crisis. And I must tell you, from Prime Minister Modi to our governments, people at large have been so supportive. The efforts have been so phenomenal. I can vouch that no one sleeps hungry. The government is doing so much, administration is doing so much, the people at large doing so much. Every social organization has come forward to take care of downtrodden and a weaker section. So I feel the people have analyzed that at the cost of severe economic, social and personal challenges which this isolation and lockdown brings, but our gains are going to be phenomenal in terms of good health and preventing the high mortality and morbidity which we see in the west of the world. So I'm sure we'll turn or emerge out to be most disciplined country with and as a strong country. And I would also convey my fellow countrymen, please bear the pain and discomfort of isolation for next few weeks to be a strong country to tide over this crisis. As a doctor, I would suggest.
But some sections of society are more vulnerable and are facing, you know, the brunt of the lockdown. Migrant workers in particular, you know, women from the poor classes. And there have been several reports, even here, in Rajasthan, of people not having adequate access to food and ration.
You need to compare the minor issues with the major issues. The major issue in front of country is to prevent the massive suffering, to prevent the massive death figures if you extrapolate the outcome of Italy and America to Indian population. The minor issue is that it is responsibility of not only government and the administration, but all of us, including me, that we need to take care of every downtrodden, every daily wage workers, every person whom we find needy and hungry. I think it's a responsibility of all of us to join hands to take care of these issues. I absolutely agree with the hardships created to them, but you have to weigh the hardships which are correctable by support of all of us and just extrapolate the morbidity and mortality dreaded figures to Indian population from Italy and America. But yes, we all of us need to join hand and take vow that we need to protect our needy, downtrodden daily wages and people at the lowest strata so that we emerge as a strong nation.
Do you believe that the lockdown should be extended? And if so, how can the government, you know, do a better job of implementing the lockdown?
On the statistical and epidemiological studies, if we are able to maintain the lockdown or the isolation till middle of May, we will be a winner country. We'll tide over the crisis. As far as you telling the government doing, I think world over, we are getting the compliments, accolades, and appreciation of what our government is doing. So they are already doing what is beyond imagination by the rest of the world. Probably it is only governmental support that things have been so successful in our country. Now they are already doing, now it is our turn, the turn of the every citizen of country to join hands of the government and to percolate the benefit, the support to the lowest downtrodden region. I probably have doctor friends world over and they are full of compliments and appreciation what our governments are doing. Probably they couldn't imagine that governments could be so supportive and so proactive. It is responsibility of all of us. And I would appeal to every fellow countryman of mine that please make sure that we take care of a similar fellow countryman who is deprived and who is missing something in his life to make the country stronger and to tide over this crisis.
Thank you so much for your time, sir.